Hi everyone, this is Meenakshi Ramesh from tapyourwaytohealing.com. Today is day 4, April 4th. I'm doing this video series for the Autism Awareness Month. I want to give a quick recap of the basic recipe that I showed you yesterday. So the basic recipe, when you do the basic recipe, first pick a problem or an issue that you want to work on. Measure the intensity of the problem on a scale of 0 to 10. And then the third step is start using the basic recipe, which is, you know, you start here at the side of the hand saying the even though statement. Even though I have this problem, I deeply and completely accept myself. So you say that 3 times and then you go around the points addressing the problem, giving the problem a voice. And then after you complete one round, you go back and measure the intensity to see if anything has shifted. And you basically repeat the steps till you get to a zero. Any shift from an, even for example, from an 8 to a 6 is progress. Every little step that you make, shift that you make, is a progress towards, you know, giving you that freedom and stress relief. So I do want to say that before you start tapping, always take full responsibility for your own well-being. And this is really not a replacement of any medical treatment. So if you have some health related issues, you need to consult a doctor always, you know, that is always there, because I'm not a medical doctor. So this is not a replacement is for any health related issues, for any health, medical treatment that you're taking. That's something I want to share. And keep yourself hydrated when you're tapping, because we are dealing with the electrical circuit of the body. So drink lots of water when you're tapping. So when you start tapping, when you complete one round, it can take anywhere between 30 seconds to a minute, depending on the pace in which you're tapping. So I really encourage you to tap for 5 minutes every day. So set a timer on your phone and you can get started with the tapping. Because the only way you're going to experience some changes, some benefits, is by doing the tapping. The other thing that I want to share is about energy. We all are beings of energy. And emotions is again energy in motion. So when we are tapping, we are releasing the stress or the stuckness around the emotion that we are feeling. And that is what we are discharging through the tapping. So I'm still talking about working only on yourself and not using the tapping with your child. Why it is important? Because if you talk to anybody, any parent or caregiver who has worked with a child on the spectrum, they will tell you that these people, these individuals, have a special way of connecting with you. They are very sensitive to energies and they can pick up your energy right away. So that is why it's very important that you use this tool on yourself, work on yourself first, and keep your energy body and energy hygiene really clean so that you feel energized and you're at your best. And you won't feel so triggered once you do tapping on a regular basis. If you're in the middle of a crisis or a stressful situation, you will be more calm and regulated, so that you can help your child in the best possible manner. That's all for today. I will see you tomorrow. Bye.